Hi dear students, in this video I am going to discuss about cold application. So this is the chapter of therapeutic nursing care and the subject is fundamental of nursing. So for GNM first year I am going to discuss about this. So what is meant by cold application and what is the uses of cold application and as a nurse how she is going to do this procedure on the patient, that thing now I will explain. So first we will see what is meant by cold application. So cold application is a simple and inexpensive therapy. So by name itself you can understand that it is a simple and inexpensive therapy and it is non-pharmacological intervention for pain management. So it is the meaning of cold application. So one more time I will read it. Cold application is a simple and inexpensive therapy and it is non-pharmacological intervention for pain management. So next we will see uses of cold application. So what are the uses of by doing this cold application? So first one is this cold application relieves pain. So it relieves the pain. And next uses is what? That is prevents edema and reduces the inflammation. So not only the pain and it can prevent the edema. So edema and reduces the inflammation. So this is the second use of cold application. And next thing, controlled hemorrhage. So the patient is have uncontrollable hemorrhage. There is a chance to decrease the hemorrhage when by taking this cold application. So this is the uses of cold application. Due to this cold application there is a chance to decrease control the hemorrhage in the patient. And next one is reduce the body temperature. So it can use for reduce the body temperature also, mostly hyperpyrexia. So such type of condition if the body temperature is high, so that in the case cold application is they can take cold application. So to reduce the body temperature. So these are the uses of cold application. So one more time I am reading. First one is cold relieves the pain and next one is it prevents edema and reduces the inflammation and third one is it controls the hemorrhage. And fourth one is reduce the body temperature. So these are the uses of cold application. And next we will see what are the equipment is required for this cold application and what is the uses of those articles and as a nurse how she is going to do this procedure. That thing now we will see. So equipment. In equipments, articles and what is the purpose of these articles. So that thing now I will explain. So in equipments, in article, first article is a big towel. So what is the use of this big towel? To keep ice cubes. So in articles, first they have to take a big towel. And what is the purpose of that big towel? To keep ice cubes. So we have seen that is cold application. So how they are going to do this cold application? By using ice. So this is the first purpose in articles. A big towel for use. What is the use of this big towel? So to keep ice cubes. And second one is an ice bath with cover. So after taking a big towel, second article is ice bath. So ice bath with cover. For what? To provide cold application. So through this ice only they are going to apply cold application. So first one is a big towel to keep ice cubes and second one is an ice bag with the cover. So for what? To provide a cold application. And third one is a Macintosh with the towel. So what is the purpose of taking this Macintosh and with towel? So to protect the bed. So when you are going to give cold application to the patient, so this ice may become water. So due to that water there is a chance to wet off the bed. So in order to prevent that thing they are taking this Macintosh and with towel. So they spread the Macintosh and towel under the patient. So that the bed may not wet. So that for that purpose they are taking the Macintosh with towel. So what is the purpose of Macintosh with towel? To protect the bed. And next one is a roll of tape or bandage. So what is the purpose of taking this roll of paper bandage? To secure the bag. So we have seen that is in second article that they were taking an ice bag with cover. So we have seen that they were taking that is ice bag with cover. So whereas come here is small, a roll of tape or bandage. What is the purpose to take this thing? So to secure the bag. So for bag purpose, to secure that bag purpose they are taking. And next one is a small container with salt. So what is the purpose of taking this small container, the tube with salt? So to sprinkle on ice. So in first article they have taken, in second article they have taken an ice. So on that ice they are going to sprinkle this salt. And next one is a small spoon. So what is the purpose of taking this small spoon? To take ice pieces. So from what is the purpose of taking this small spoon? To take ice pieces from dough. So this is the purpose of taking small spoon. And next one is a duster. So what is the use of taking this duster? This duster is for to wipe bag and filling. So after filling the bag, whatever the water is at outside of the bag, for that purpose. So to wipe those things, they are taking duster. And last, next one is small ice cubes. So for what is the purpose of taking these small ice cubes? To fill in the bag. So after taking the small ice cubes, they are going to fill in the bag. And last one is kidney tray and paper bag. So what is the use of taking this kidney tray and paper bag? To discard or whatever the waste things they will discard in kidney, in paper bag. So that thing they are, that is the purpose of kidney tray and paper bag. So these are the articles are required for doing this cold application. And for those articles, what is the purpose of taking that thing? Now I have told. So one more time I will explain. First article is a big towel. Purpose is to keep ice cubes. And second one is an ice bag with cover. And is what is the purpose? To provide cold application. And third one is a Macintosh with towel. For what is the purpose? To protect the bed. And fourth one is a roll of tape or bandage. It is for to secure the bag, ice bag. And next one is a small container with salt. So this salt they will sprinkle on the ice. And next thing, a small spoon. And for what? To take small pieces of to take ice pieces. And next one is a duster. For what? To wipe whatever the water is outside of the bag. And next one is small ice cubes. For what? To fill in the ice bag. To fill in the bag. Last one is kidney tray and paper bag. So whatever the waste products are there, that thing they will discard in the paper bag. So these are the articles for doing this procedure. So next we will see the procedure, how they are going to do this procedure. So dear students, we are discussing about cold application. So what is mean by cold application and what is the uses of cold application? And next, what are the article is required for this procedure and what is the purpose of taking that articles, that thing we have discussed till now. So now we will see the procedure. So before the procedure, how the nurse is going to prepare the patient for the procedure, that thing now I will explain. So as a nurse, before going to do this procedure, she has to explain the patient. So she has to explain the procedure to the patient, and she should take how much duration it will take and what is the purpose of doing this procedure. The thing the nurse has to explain. So by that the patient can cooperate for this procedure. And next thing, as a nurse, she has to provide comfortable position to the patient. If the patient is required, she has to keep the screen. So these are the things she has to follow when before starting the procedure. And next thing, if we'll go for procedure, in procedure as a nurse, first she has to wash her hands for what? To prevent cross infection. And second one is break the ice into small pieces. So what is the why they have to break the ice in small pieces? So it is easy for insertion of ice into the bag. If they are breaking that ice into small pieces, there is it is easy to insert into the ice bag. So the big ice they cannot insert to the ice bag, so that they are breaking the ice into small pieces so that it easy to insert into the ice bag. And second step is sprinkle sodium chloride. So what is the use of this sprinkle sodium chloride? Salt lowers the melting point. So for the melting point they are taking this sprinkle. So they are sprinkling this sodium chloride on the ice. And next one is check the ice bag for leakage by pouring water into it. So third one is they have to check whether the bag is correct or not. Is there any leakage is not present or not? That thing they have to see. So how they have to see? By pouring hot water. If they are pouring any water, it may come out. If any leakage is present, any hole is present, means automatically there is a chance to get leakage. So that purpose they are pouring water and they are checking any leakage is present or not. So that is the to ensure that the bag is in a good working condition or not. So that is the purpose of checking the bag. And next thing, after pouring water into it, and next step is empty the bag and fill it with ice. So after checking the bag, they have to empty whatever the water they have they pour in that bag. That all those things they have to empty it and they have to fill it with ice two by third. So that much amount of ice they have to fill in the bag. So for what? To make the bag light in weight. If they are taking this much amount of ice into the bag, there is a light in weight. So the bag weight may be light. So for that purpose, they have to take only this much amount of ice into the bag. And next one is keep the bag on a flat surface and squeeze out the air. So after filling ice in the bag, next step, what is that? So keep the bag on a flat surface and squeeze out the air. So whatever the air is present in the bag, that thing they have to squeeze. So if they are squeezing the bag, by doing squeeze, keep the bag on a flat surface and squeeze out the air. They have to keep the bag on a flat surface position. And next thing, after keeping that, they have to squeeze out the air from the bag. And next one is, after doing this step, next one is screw the cap and well and wide. So after squeezing the air, they have to screw the cap how well and wide to ensure that bag is not leaking. So by doing this, they can see that, so that they can understand that bag is not leaking. And next thing, put on a flannel cover. So on that bag, they have to put on a flannel cover. And next thing, explain the procedure to the patient. So when they are going to do on the patient, they have to explain the procedure to the patient and spread the Macintosh and purpose of spreading this Macintosh and towel? Already we have seen the purpose of Macintosh and towel in the articles, but here also the uses of Macintosh and towel is same thing. So to protect pillow cover. So for that purpose, they are spreading the Macintosh and towel under the patient. And next one is the ice bag is applied for about half an hour. So after explaining the procedure, after arranging everything, after explaining to the patient, and after seeing, after arranging the Macintosh and towel, next one is the ice bag should be applied for half an hour. And this is the procedure. So after complete this procedure, as a nurse, what is the responsible for? What is the responsible of the nurse after procedure to the client? So after the procedure, she has to wash her hands, and next thing, immediately she should documentation is very important. So whatever the procedure they are doing on the patient, they have to document in the patient record, that is must and should. And next thing, after documentation, next thing is she has to assess the client condition. So how is the condition of the client? So how it is pain and whether it is reduced or not. By doing this whole application, how you are feeling, how is your opinion after doing this procedure, whether it is comfortable or not. So that thing, the nurse has to assess the condition of the patient. So that next thing, after assessing the client condition, next thing she has to wash the bag and dry it. And next thing, for what they have to wash the bag? For next, for reuse. And not only washing, next after dry it, they have to keep the powder between the layer of the rubber and store after filling it with air. So after washing and after drying it, they have to keep the powder between the layer of the rubber and store it with filling the air. So for what? To store it properly. For next use, they have to store it properly. So this is the purpose of washing the bag. So this is the procedure of cold application. So we have seen that is what is meant by cold application and what is the uses of cold application and what are the article is required for this procedure, and each article, what is the purpose of taking that article for this procedure we have seen. And next thing, before doing this procedure as a nurse, how she is going to counsel the patient. And the next thing is procedure. In the procedure, step by step we have seen. So how the nurse is going to prepare the ice cubes and how she is going to fill in the bag and how they are checking whether it is leakage or not and how much amount of ice they have to take, and that things we have seen. So that how much time they have to keep this ice bag on the patient, and after doing this procedure, how the nurse has to assess the client condition and how she has to take care the articles. That thing, and next thing, compulsory she has to document this procedure. So these things now we came to know by seeing this code application. So completed this topic. Thank you.